Dear students, we are going to learn about the role of fermentation in food processing. To start the various food fermentations, we will learn about the cheese fermentation today. Cheese is a milk product obtained by coagulation of milk protein. It is often said that cheese making is both a science and art. Cheese is a fermented milk product. It is the consolidated curd of milk solids in which milk fat is entrapped by coagulated casein. Typically, the yield of cheese from milk is 10%. Essentially, there are 9 key steps in cheese making. They are pre-treatment of raw milk, addition of lactic acid, starter culture bacteria and coagulant rennet, coagulation of the milk followed by cutting of the curd, cooking the curd to temperatures from 32 to 54 degrees Celsius, which together with the acid production by the microorganisms assist in the expulsion of whey from the curd, separation of the curds and whey, molding and pressing the curd at low or relatively high pressure, or known as cheddaring, salting or brining and molding of the cheese curd, ripening of the cheese at temperatures ranging from 6 to 24 degrees Celsius to allow the characteristic flavor and texture to develop, and the final step is the packing of cheese. So, these are the 9 key steps in cheese making which are shown in this image. There is the pre-treatment of raw milk where the milk is heated. Then there is the addition of starter culture and rennet, cutting the curd, cooking the curd at 32 to 54 degrees Celsius. Then there is separation of the curd and whey followed by cheddaring, salting or brining and molding, and then there will be foam and press to mold the cheese into a required shape, followed by ripening or aging of the cheese, and finally the cheese will be packed. So we are going to learn the process of cheese making step by step. First is the pre-treatment of raw milk. Milk is the basic ingredient and the quality of cheese depends on milk. So, the biological, physical and chemical properties of the milk have to be controlled for a good quality cheese. Also, the milk for cheese production must be free from antibiotics and any other sanitizing agent that might interfere with the microbial fermentation. The milk may contain some suspended materials like leukocytes or particulate matter. So techniques like homogenization, clarification, filtration, centrifugation and vacuum treatment are done for the clarification or the removal of suspended particles in the milk. Also for the removal of leukocytes and other particulate matter. A milk with a high microbial count or a high microbial contamination may result in the development of undesirable flavors in cheese. So, the microflora and their enzymatic activity in the milk should be controlled by pasteurization, where the milk will be treated either at 72 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds or at 63 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. After pasteurization, the milk will be cooled down to the fermentation temperature, which is generally between 29 to 31 degrees Celsius. Sometimes the fresh milk will be having low calcium content, so they may need addition of calcium chloride, which is done after pasteurization. The calcium chloride is essential for proper curd formation. The next step is addition of lactic acid starter bacteria and coagulant rennet enzyme. During this step, The milk proteins are coagulated to form a solid curd. The curd formed during the coagulation of milk contains fat globulins, water-soluble material, and water along with the casein protein, the coagulated casein protein. The whey, the liquid portion, contains few proteins like lactalbumin, globulin, and riboflavin. So, the coagulation of milk is done by using lactic acid starter culture and Rennet enzyme. The starter culture may be either a mesophilic starter, such as strains of Lactococcus lactis, or a thermophilic starter may be used, for example, Lactobacillus helveticus, Lactobacillus casei, Lactobacillus lactis, Lactobacillus delbrueckii, and Streptococcus thermophilus, etc. Next is the enzyme Rennet. Rennet is a preparation from the fourth stomach or abomasum of suckling calves, lambs, or goats. It contains the proteolytic enzyme renin or chymosin, which cleaves K-casein. K-casein is a type of casein protein which is important in maintaining the colloidal stability of milk proteins. So, cleavage of K-casein causes the casein protein to be unstable, and it will aggregate in the presence of calcium ions to form a gel. As the gel forms, it will entrap fats and forms white creamy lumps known as the curd. Microbial rennets are also available, which are produced from fungi such as Mucor mihi, Mucor bacillus, and Endothea parasitica. So, the lactic acid and rennet, it will cause the milk to curdle, which separate the curd and whey. Curd is made of milk solids, fats, and proteins, and whey is mostly water. So, the lactic acid and rennet cause the milk to curdle. The role of starter organism is both crucial and complex in milk curdling and cheese fermentation. Their central function is the fermentation of the milk sugar lactose to lactic acid, thereby decreasing the pH. The acidic pH increases the shelf life and safety of the cheese, and it will give a sharp flesh flavor to the cheese. The acid also aids in the moisture expulsion and the curd shrinkage, and it also helps to achieve the final cheese texture. The next step is the coagulation followed by cutting the curd. After 30 to 45 minutes of rennet and culture addition, coagulation of milk will be complete and the process of whey expulsion from the curd can be started. We know curd is a coagulated solid part formed after coagulation. The curds will be cut into approximately 1 cm cubes for whey expulsion. Next is scalding or cooking of the curd to temperatures ranging from 32 to 54 degrees Celsius. Whey expulsion is further assisted by scalding when the curd is heated to a high temperature, 32 to 54 degrees Celsius, where the curd will shrink and become firm. Next is the separation of the curds and whey. Now, the curd can be readily separated from the liquid whey by holding the mixture in a cheesecloth. Next step is the molding and pressing of the curd, also known as cheddaring. Manual or mechanical cheddaring is done where the curd blocks are piled up to compress and fuse the curds, expelling more whey. This will be done at low pressure for soft cheese or relatively high pressure for hard cheese. At the end of cheddaring, the curd has a characteristic fibrous appearance. The next stage is a salting or brining. The blocks of curd are milled into small chips and 1.5 to 2% weight by weight of salt will be added. Some other ingredients such as coloring agents, herbs, or microbial inoculum for ripening, etc. also may be added during this step. Salt is important for the taste and it also aids in the moisture and acidity control of cheese. It also helps to limit the growth of undesirable proteolytic bacteria. The salted curd is again made into blocks, which are then pressed to expel trapped air and whey and molded into required shapes. The next stage is the ripening of cheese. Finally, the cheese is ripened or matured at about 10 degrees Celsius to allow the flavor development. And this process may take up to months or years. Ripening involves the modification of proteins and fats by microbial and milk proteases and lipases. Transformation of the elastic and chalky curd with an acidic flavor to a ductile, full-flavored cheese is achieved through proper cheese ripening. During cheese ripening process, there will be breakdown of proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, etc., resulting in a contribution of flavor and texture to the cheese. The development of flavor and texture in a cheese during the cheese ripening also depends upon the pH, presence of salts, temperature, humidity, composition of cheese, etc. The proteases and peptidases from the starter culture and rennet release free amino acids such as glutamic acid and leucine, and this will contribute to the cheese flavor. In some cases, a high proportion of hydrophobic amino acid peptides will result in a bitter taste to the cheese. Some countries allow acceleration of flavor development through the addition of commercial enzyme preparations. Lysozyme may be added in the manufacture of hard-cooked Emmental, Gouda and Gruyere type cheeses to prevent the growth of the spoilage organism Clostridium thiobutricum. Propionibacterium fruderenchi is used for the production of Swiss type cheeses. These bacteria modify the flavor and generate gas bubbles that results in the holes or eye formation within the cheese. Blue-veined cheeses such as Danish Blue, Gorgonzola, Roquefort and Stilton use the organism Penicillium roqueforti. Young cheeses are usually punctured with stainless steel rolls to promote the fungal growth by increasing the levels of oxygen. Cheeses are ripened for up to a year, during which they develop the characteristic blue veins and the aroma and flavor develop due to the presence of fungal metabolites. Surface ripened soft cheeses such as Camembert and Brie use the organism Penicillium camemberti. This mold will grow on the surface of the cheese for about 1 to 6 months to produce the characteristic white crust or rind, and the hydrolytic enzymes secreted into the cheese will modify the flavor and texture of the cheese. Propionibacterium species, yeast, micrococci and Brevibacterium linens impart the characteristic flavor of the Limburger cheese. Next is the cheese packing. Cheese is normally packed with a protective coating such as vegetable oil or special plastic films. The shelf life of cheese varies with the type, but it is generally much superior to that of milk. This is due to the increased shelf life is due to the reduced pH of the cheese, the low water activity due to whey removal, and also the dissolution of salt in the remaining moisture. Under these conditions, in a cheese, yeast and molds are the main organisms of concern, which are effectively controlled by the traditional procedures to exclude air such as waxing, or by modern practices such as vacuum packing. Let us look into the problems which are generally encountered in cheese manufacture. Bacteriophage infections of the starter culture is a major problem in cheese fermentation. When this occurs, acidification will be slowing or even stops, causing financial losses to the producer, as well as there will be an increased risk that the pathogens will be able to grow in the milk and curd, thereby spoiling the cheese. An important source of phage in cheese making is the starter culture themselves, which carry lysogenic phages within them that may be induced into a virulent state later. This problem could be avoided by the use of phage inhibitory media, rotation of strains, and phage insensitive bacterial strains. These are used to tackle the situation. However, phage infections continue to cause problems in the cheese industry. Now, we will discuss about the types of cheese. There are various types and flavors of cheese, and about 1,000 types of cheese have been described depending upon the properties and treatment of the milk, the method of production, the various conditions such as the temperature, properties of the coagulum, and also depending upon the local preferences. Classification of cheeses are difficult due to this diversity. The most successful approach of classification of cheese is based on the moisture content, milk type, and the role of microorganisms in cheese ripening. There are mainly soft cheese, semi-soft cheese, hard cheese, and very hard cheese. Soft cheese contain 50-80% moisture, and they may be ripened or unripened, cooked, salt cured, or pickled. Examples are cottage cheese, cream cheese, mozzarella, camembert, brie, feta, etc. Semi-soft cheese contain 39-50% moisture, and they may be ripened by internal mold growth, or ripened by bacteria and surface microorganisms, or ripened mainly by bacteria. Examples are Roquefort, Stilton, Danish Blue, Limburger, Brick, Gouda, Edam, etc. Hard cheeses contain less than 39% moisture, and they may be either ripened by bacteria, resulting in the formation of eye or hole, or they may be unripened by bacteria. Examples are Cheddar, Emmental, Gruyere, etc. Very hard cheeses contain less than 34% moisture, and examples are Parmesan, Romano, Grana, etc. So, we discussed about cheese fermentation, the various stages involved in cheese fermentation, and now we know the importance of microbial fermentation in preparing a good quality cheese. Thank you so much for listening.